Go ahead and leave. There's nothing I can do.
I gotta put him on right now.
Go ahead and put him on.
Any more tapes on there? Enough?
Or well, I don't know. It's going to how long his conversation is. Go ahead.
All right.
Assist the communities, cities, and states affected by the recent power failure. I've asked all agencies of the government to render every possible assistance to restore power and communications and to ease any of the problems resulting from the power failure. Close quote. Don't think we can call for an investigation at this time because we may have a panic problem in New York, but I think we can put this out and...
Yeah, I think Bill's already done that here.
Has he?
You can check with him as soon as you hang up.
I will.
I'll sure see at FAA and trains and buses and everything that the order be stopped. Don't transport any people into any of these areas. Just stop them and turn them back.
Okay, right.
Because you'll be landing at these airports and things of that kind, and they'll just be going into dark places.
Right.
Just turn them away, and I'd see if we could that just put a freeze on these things. Then I'd also try to be positive that we're moving people in to see what happens in these elevator situations, these emergency ones. I guess the hospitals have emergency units. What does a building like Empire State have?
I don't know.
When they get caught in the elevator at 5 o'clock, they just suffocate down the damn elevator.
Right. I've got to, I think the mayor is calling me now.
So let's see what the defense people can do, what's available for the emergency things. Hospitals, first people going in traveling, hospitals, elevators, and things of that type. And no one has any idea what's caused it, do they?
And still, it looks now as though it is the Niagara Power Station and grids that have gone out and the power failure that spread. As I said, there are some lights going back on, at least in Massachusetts, so. I just, we're trying to get an estimate from Buford as to how long the power failure is likely to continue. This is very important in the New York situation in terms of the possibility of Bob having to use some troops to keep order and prevent panic.
Well, I'll let you go, and what I would do is call in your press people and say the president heard it on the 5 o'clock news. When did it go out?
I don't know, Mr. President. Oh, I can find out.
Did I inform you?
I'd say the president heard it on the radio as a bulletin down there shortly after the power went out.
I was in my car and I immediately called. I called you, didn't I?
Yes, sir.
Had you heard it before?
No, I hadn't, Mr. President.
And since then, I've talked to McNamara, talked to Ellington, and I'm keeping in constant touch with you and Moyers, and here's what's happening. But I think that McNamara ought to have all of his core area commanders, his folks in that area, talking to him, get any suggestions, get their reports right back to him. Buford, too. But one thing I'm thinking about, planes in the air that'll be landing at Kennedy and LaGuardia and all those places. And we just got to find out where it went out and what caused it and what we can do about it.
That's right, sir. We are doing that.
The statement's already out here, so we're protecting. But I'd tell Bill what I'm doing. I'd call in our reporters there at the White House and just say the president has called me, Ellington, et cetera.
Where is Bill? Is he back?
He's to Austin.
Okay, fine.
He's to Austin. Just to Austin headquarters.
Okay.
Now, McNamara and Rusk and them are due to come down here Thursday morning. man. I don't know what time they're planning to come, but Bundy ought to let Marvin know. And I would hope this early Thursday they can get up without ruining their night's sleep. In other words, I would hope they'll have most of the day here. And I would guess if 7:30 is not too early for them, that's 6:30 here. That'll put them at the ranch about 3 hours and a half, about 10.
No, that'll be late for McNamara. As a matter of fact, he usually starts work about 7.
That's right, but Rusk and Mac Bundy might not. If they could all do it at 7, it'd be that much better. But if they left Andrews at 7:30, they'd have to leave the White House at 7 by chopper.
Okay, Mr. President. I'll...
All right.